Hi everyone, welcome to this video tutorial on how to create a Blazor Web Assembly application and add a message component to it. Using the Blazor message component, you can display information with different severity types and predefined styles. I will show you a few of the component's basic features like changing variants, showing or hiding severity in close icons, customization, and templates. Let me start with the application creation process. A Blazor application can be created using Visual Studio 2019 or 2022, Visual Studio Code, or JetBrains Writer. In this video, I'll show you how to create a Blazor Web Assembly application using Visual Studio 2022. Make sure that you have installed either the latest or the required SDK version starting from .NET Core SDK 3.1.8. Open Visual Studio 2022 and choose Create a New Project from the dashboard. Choose the Blazor Web Assembly app and click Next. Name your project and click Next. Then, select .NET 6.0 as the target framework and click Create. A project is created and ready to use. Now I will show you the step-by-step process for adding the message component to this project. First, the Syncfusion Blazor notifications package needs to be installed. Open the NuGet package manager, search for the Syncfusion Blazor notifications package, and install it in your application. After installation, you will see the package added to this application. Navigate to the imports.razor page and import the syncfusion.blazor.notifications namespace. Then, the Syncfusion Blazor services should be registered. In the program.cs file, import the Syncfusion Blazor namespace and register the Syncfusion Blazor service using the addSyncfusionBlazor method. From the 2022 Volume 1 release, the ignore script isolation option is enabled by default, so no need to enable it explicitly. Next, register the license with a valid key using the register license method to avoid the license validation message. To add the theme to the app, open the NuGet package manager, search for Syncfusion Blazor themes package, and then install it. After installation, you will see the package added to this application. Navigate to the index.html page within the root folder and include the Syncfusion Bootstrap 5 CSS reference from the installed package. By default, the ignore script isolation option is set to true, so I add the script reference manually to improve loading performance of the app. If you want to know more about the Blazor WebAssembly app and how to add Syncfusion components to it, you can check out the video linked in the card above and in the description below. The configuration steps are done, so let's move on to adding the Blazor message component to the index.razor page. In this example, I'm going to display the message when the age entered in the input element is not between 18 and 60. First, I add the label, enter your age. Then I add an input tag with the @bindValue attribute. @bindValue attribute triggers the value changed event of the input element. In the @code block, I declare the variable age value and assign this variable to the @bindValue property. Then I write an if condition to check whether the age is less than 18 or greater than 60 and display the message component by adding the sfMessage tag. Assign the content, enter a valid age between 18 and 60. Then I add the style element and specify the width as 300 pixels to the built-in class eMessage. This class will be added to message component by default. Now, let me run the application by pressing the F5 key. Check now, a message is displayed when the age value entered is not between 18 and 60. Next, I will show you the other features of the message component in the same example. First, I will show you the variants. The different variants available are filled, outlined, and text. The default is text. Here, severity is differentiated using a text color and a light background color. To change the content appearance, I include the variant property and set message variant to filled. You can see the filled message variant. The severity is differentiated using a text color and a dark background color. Next, change the variant to outlined. See, the severity is differentiated using a text color and a border without background. Let's see the different severity types: normal, info, success, warning, and error. To show warning, set the severity property and set the message severity to warning. Check now, severity is changed from the default normal type to warning. There is also an option to customize the alignment of the content displayed in the message. By default, the content is aligned to the left. You can change it to center or right using the content alignment property. I choose center. Check now, the content is at the center. Next, I will show you how to show or hide the icons in the message. By default, severity icon is shown. I can hide the severity icon by disabling the show icon property and show the close icon by enabling the show close icon property. Check now, severity icon is hidden and close icon is shown. Finally, I will show you how to customize the message component. You can customize a Blazor message by adding an icon or image, buttons, and changing the content alignment and appearance. Here, I'm going to include the dismiss button to close the message. I can show or hide the message by using the visible property. In the @code block, declare the Boolean variable is message visible and assign this variable to the visible property. To use Syncfusion button, open the NuGet package manager and search for Syncfusion Blazor buttons package and install it. Then import the button namespace. Inside the message content, I add the SF button tag and set its content to dismiss. Then include the onClick event and assign the callback method dismissClick. I define this method here. Then set isMessageVisible variable to false. Here, assign the value true to enable the message on sample initial loading. Since I'm using a button to close the message, disable the showCloseIcon property. Check now, when I click the dismiss button, the message will be closed. In this video, I have shown you how to create a Blazor Web Assembly application, add a message component to it, and configure a few of its basic features. You can download this working example from the GitHub link in the description below. I've also shared a link where you can see about obtaining a free license key to use our Blazor products if you're eligible for our community license. Thank you for watching this video. If you found it useful, please give it a like and subscribe to our channel.